You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
With Vegeta now having to finally arrive on planet Sadala following his trip into Universe 6, tension seems to be brewing as both Kamen and Orin seem to have a sinister plan up their sleeve in further having to reignite their hatred and causing a war between both the Tuffles and the Saiyans. Both Kamen and Orin are now looking to do everything they can in order to get the better of the Universe 6 Saiyans. However, with Vegeta now presently on planet Sadala and being one of the strongest warriors within Universe 7, how exactly are Kamen and Orin going to be dealing with this situation? Once, of course, they inevitably do come across Vegeta in battle, and more importantly, going forward, will Kamen and Orin be able to fully execute their plans, or is Vegeta simply going to be there in stopping them from doing so? Now, before we dive any further into this video, if you are new to the channel and of course have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, and want to be kept up to date with everything in regards to Dragon Ball, the Dragon Ball Super manga, and everything involving the Dragon Ball IP, then I do encourage you guys to go on over and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on this channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited to see what the future holds in regards to the Dragon Ball franchise. And with all that being said, I want to thank you all so much for your support, and let's dive straight into the video. As the second chapter of Dragon Ball Super Sadala continues with the Saiyan King having to be shown inside of his spacecraft out of nowhere, one of his men went on to further inform the King by telling him, "Sir, those waves are causing our systems to malfunction. We can't move." And with the Saiyan King visibly concerned, he then went on to respond, "Damn it, their goal must be to capture us. They could easily destroy our ship." But then, it would only then appear as though there is something wrong with Skirat, who just so happens to be on board the same ship as Planet Sadala's Saiyan King, and through that, right then and there, we get to see how there is something wrong with Skirat, who we've seen in the first manga chapter fight off both Kamen and Orin, as only then the big reveal happens, and it looks as though Kamen and Orin had infected and infiltrated Skirat's body in now causing him to become one of the Neo machines. And as, of course, everyone on board is absolutely perplexed by the idea of what had just happened, Skirat then went on to comment, "Oh, we have big plans for the Saiyans, but before we can execute our plan, we need you." As one of the Saiyan individuals went on to respond, "So, you must be the rogue Tuffles I've heard so much about. What do you want? Your empire is gone. Accept it. You Tuffles have already been greedy. Everything your people touch turns as gray and dead as your consideration for others." As the Neo machines then went on to respond, "We wiped the planet clean so the Tuffle Empire could be born anew. We were all aware of the Tuffles' destruction. After all, we are responsible." As we only then have a flashback of the original destruction of the Tuffles, it was only then later depicted that both Kamen and Orin at one point were in fact normal, as they further went on to share their story by commenting, "But we both fell ill. We were Tuffle royalty. We were loved and adored by everyone, but his attempts failed. He tried everything to save us. Our father robbed planets for their resources to create his new Super Tuffle Empire. His goal was to free the Tuffles of the dangers of normal biological life." Which basically goes on to illustrate the point that Kamen and Orin's father was in fact some sort of a planetary bidding kind of individual in which he wanted to get rid of all biological life. So, as we then get to see how we make our way towards an individual that goes by the name of Piero, he then went on to tell the King Tuffle, "There is another option. My top military scientists have developed a supercomputer capable of reviving your children using their DNA, but new and improved. Truly Super Tuffles." As the King Tuffle went on to shout, "Damn it! What can we do now? They're gone! As Piero went on to respond, we have a machine capable of draining said planets of their resources and using it to create these new super Tuffles. We just need to find suitable planets, but we would need resources. And not just any, the substance we need is only available on ancient planets rich in nature. Nature is destined to die, for the improvement of the universe and the Tuffle Empire. Order your top military agents to find us suitable planets at once, says King Tuffle. Once we've drained the planets of their resources, we will continue to develop advanced cities as well as sell them so that we can sustain this process. Do whatever is necessary, as we only then observe how Kamen and Orin were in fact beginning to change and be altered by, of course, this technology. Piero went on to ask, they're perfect. Did you pull it off? As an individual that goes by the name of Dr. Plum went on to respond, and improve the lives of the Tuffles by any means necessary? Yes. Their primary objective is to expand the Tuffle Empire. Good, says Piero. Their programming is complete. Let's have a family reunion. We're ready, as we only then get to see how once, of course, Kamen and Orin were activated, the first person to go down was, of course, Dr. Plum, followed by Piero, who went on to shout, "No! Why?" Because very similar to Android 17 and Android 18, Kamen and Orin had been released from their testing chambers as they went on to tell the King Tuffle, "Hey, Dad, Pop, kids, it's me, your father." But at the end of the day, it didn't matter, because just like Dr. Gero had suffered the same fate by the hands of 17, they further went on to put their father down, as one of them went on to respond, "This is for your own good, father." Ready, brother? As the other scientists and individuals are shown trying to flee the scene, because these Neo machines are solely now programmed for the purpose of rebuilding the Tuffle race, but at the same time, destroying those around them. Again, very similar to 17 and 18, dare I say more so from future Trunks' timeline than the one we've seen in the past, but even then, as they went on to dispose of all of the remaining individuals in that corridor, and as they went on to just destroy everything around them, one of them went on to take a piece of hair and putting it inside of a vial by responding, "Don't worry, everyone, you will return." Well, back to work. So now, we understand that these individuals are trying to wipe everybody off the face of the planet, but at the same time, retrieve their DNA as a means of having them be reborn as Neo machines, as we only then go back to the Neo machines now. Skirat, who had been infected by one of them, went on to respond, "The rest is ancient history. As you know, the planets our father targeted were under the protection of the Sadala Defense Force. You have outposts spread all across the galaxy. You and your elite are going to be very useful to us." "You monster," says one of the Saiyans. "Kamen, when you're ready." As it was only at that moment where we get to see how in fact Kamen had infiltrated Planet Sadala's king, as one of the soldiers went on to respond, "Sire, what happened? Is everything okay?" "Yes," says King Sadala. "Everything is perfect." So, on board this Saiyan ship, what had basically happened was Kamen and Orin had overtaken Planet Sadala's Saiyans, including the king himself, and having to masquerade and taking over his body, but nobody else knows this other than Kamen and Orin. But even then, as we make our way back to Planet Sadala and having to see Kaba standing with Vegeta, Kaba then further went along to address the other Saiyans by telling them, "Listen, everyone, this is Vegeta, the Saiyan from the 7th universe who promised to restore ours. The king wants us all to train to be Super Saiyans. Vegeta is the one who taught me, and now he's going to help all of us reach the next level." As Vegeta responded, "That's enough, Kaba. Listen well. I have no intention of playing hero. I am here to help you all prepare so you can solve your own problems. Yes, I promised to restore this universe so I could see this planet for myself. You all better take this seriously." As, of course, the other Saiyans are shown patiently having to listen to Vegeta, Vegeta then went on to continue, "From the few of you I faced, I am not impressed. I faced threats that could easily destroy you all with ease. You must be a great hero in your universe," one of the Saiyans says. As Vegeta went on to smirk, he then went on to reply, "Kaba tells me the threat you face are space pirates. In my universe, I was royalty, and our empire destroyed and sold planets. Yes, in fact, we took the Tuffle's planet for our own." And with all the Saiyans shown having to be in absolute shock, Vegeta then went on to continue, "And you are all lucky, because if anyone knows the dirty tricks your enemies have up their sleeves, it's someone with experience on the matter," as of course Vegeta was referencing himself. And as he did, he then went on to continue, "I've thrown my past aside. It's no longer a concern to me. Think of me what you will. I am here to ensure the Saiyan's survival, but if you all prove to be unworthy, I'll destroy you all myself. And this went on to shock everyone, including Kaba, as Vegeta went on to continue, now, I need you all to report to the training arena immediately. Master, those clothes, as he went on to give Vegeta a pair of clothing, he then went on to tell him, Vados gave me something, said it was a gift from Whis, as we only then get to see how Vegeta went on to put on, for the first time, the outfit of the Universe 6 Saiyans. It was only at that point, right then and there, the Beyond Dragon Ball Super Sadala manga chapter number 2 special then comes to a close. Now, what I really enjoyed from what Jordan Lee and Monty Black had done here was the overall build-up aspect in the fact that we know now that Vegeta is willing to train the Universe 6 Saiyans in discovering the forms of Super Saiyan, but at the same time, little by little, we get to see how the Universe 6 King and the other Saiyans have been infiltrated by Kamen and Orin, so this kind of begs the question as to who the real enemies are going to be going forward, considering the fact that now Vegeta is the only ace in the hole that Planet Sadala has to get rid of Kamen and Orin. But does this mean that we're going to be getting help outside of Vegeta if things get ugly, or is Vegeta going to be the only weapon of destruction that Kaba and the other Saiyans have to potentially put down Kamen and Orin? But even more importantly is, will Kamen and Orin somehow be able to infect Vegeta, or will they be able to carry out a different plan in combating Vegeta with? Because right now, despite what it is that both Kamen and Orin do, or whoever it is that they end up infecting, really isn't going to match up to what Vegeta is currently with Super Saiyan Blue Evolution, but that could change. So in the comment section below, what I want to know from you guys is what exactly you guys want to see going forward in Dragon Ball Super Sadala manga chapter number 3. If there's anything specific that you guys believe that Jordan and Monty can include that will make the overall story better, drop your thoughts in the comment section below. Give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys enjoyed and cannot wait for the next chapter. Again, I will leave a link to that located down in the description box below for you guys to follow Jordan and Monty Black on Twitter. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life in taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more. More, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! But, Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
That I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!